Hey guys, I'm Kira, and if you would like to switch quickly between Russian and English when you type on a Mac, this is the video for you. So if you want to switch quickly between English and Russian when you're typing on a Mac, there are only two things that you need to do. The first is that you need to add Russian as an input source, and the second is that you need to figure out what shortcut you want in order to switch between English and Russian. So let's do step one. We'll first go to the Apple menu, and then find System Preferences. From there, go to Keyboard. And from there, go to Input Sources. You see we have the US flag that represents the US keyboard English layout. We're going to now click plus and add Russian. You might have to search for it, but you can see here that I've chosen it before, so it's in my frequently used keyboard area. I like the Russian phonetic keyboard. It's very, very similar to the English keyboard, and I can type very quickly in it. The other keyboards have different layouts. So we're going to click Add, and now you can see that in the upper right corner of the bar up here, there's an American flag, and if you click on that, you can switch from English to Russian as the input. The only problem now is that if you're typing in a Word document, here let's open one up, we can start typing in English, and if we want to switch to Russian, we have to come all the way up here with our cursor, make the switch, and then we can type in Cyrillic, make the switch again, and then we can type in English. That's a little bit slower than I like to do. So what we're going to do is step two, which is to figure out a shortcut that's comfortable. So let's go to the Apple menu again, choose System Preferences, and instead of Input Sources, this time we're going to go to Shortcuts. And the shortcut that I like to use is Command Space. And the reason is that my two thumbs are very convenient right there, and I can just use those two keys when I want to switch between English and Russian. And what I'm going to do is go to Input Sources in the left-hand menu here, and you can see there's a really convenient command already set up, Select Next Source in Input Menu. It has a series of keystrokes that I don't find particularly comfortable, Control Option Spacebar. I want to replace that with my shortcut. So if I select that command and select again that area where the keystrokes are, I can simply replace it by typing over it. So I'm going to type right now, Command Spacebar, and that input worked, except that it's telling me now there's an alert because that shortcut is used by another action. And you can see here that the other action is in the spotlight section. And in fact, it had already been assigned to Show Spotlight Search, which is when you go to search for something using the magnifying glass. I don't use that command that often, and so I'm willing to turn off that shortcut for this function. I can just go up to the upper right corner and click the magnifying glass. So all I have to do here is uncheck the box next to Show Spotlight Search, and I'm already done. And so let's close out of System Preferences. Here we are typing happily in English, and all of a sudden, Command Space, now we're typing in Russian. Command Space, we're typing in English again, very, very fast. And that's it.
So I hope that was helpful. Subscribe, share, and check out my video course at unlockingrussianpronunciation.org. Счастливо!